Someone else we saw today was Bob Crippen. We've spoken about him in the last hour. He lives in North Palm Beach, and he was on the very first space shuttle mission back in 1981. He now today at the very last space shuttle mission had some really strong feelings about NASA moving forward without having a way to get astronauts to the ISS.
To stand the shuttle down when we don't have another capability to put our astronauts in space, and we have to continue to do that because we do have the International Space Station flying, and we're going to be putting crews up there, but we're going to be dependent on the Russians to take them up, and we're paying for that. I feel confidence in the Russians' launch vehicle, and I've got no problem with that, but to be totally dependent on the Russians and not be able to do it ourselves is taking a back seat from where we were as far as the leaders in space.
Do the commercial rockets, and they will be the space taxi, and that gets us to and from the space station, and simultaneously do the big monster rocket. NASA's already put out the contract on the capsule. Any day now they will announce the design for the big new rocket, and then NASA can do what NASA's supposed to do, get out of Earth orbit and go explore the universe.
And that will be the next chapter for Kennedy Space Center. A lot of these facilities are available for rent for the private companies who now want to get into commercial space travel. And they will come here and use the vehicle assembly building and the launch pad and so forth.
It'll be a whole different world here. I mean, a lot of people who work here are losing their jobs, but at the same time, there's going to be new opportunities. You go back to the early 70s when the Apollo program ended and the shuttle program was just kind of starting. Went through the same transition, and for the folks here along the Space Coast, it may be a difficult short term, but perhaps long term, it may have a lot of benefits.
A lot of